he's alive. All this creativity that he thought people weren't appreciating, and yet people did.
Yeah.
You know, so it was just something that had to be able to show that to the world and let everybody see that. It's fantastic. The exhibition label showed that the artist's address was four doors away from Vincent van Gogh. So this was just such an amazing find. So we had to then start researching to make sure she actually lived at that address at the exact right time that Vincent did, because the exhibition was 1892. He lived there in 1886. So we needed to find out. So we actually had to look right through records, salon records, and we found out that she wasn't a nobody at the time. She was massive. She exhibited from 1885 to 1897, almost every year. And she got an honourable mention in 1886. So it was very difficult to find anything on her at all. But these exhibition records were brilliant. From 1885, which meant that covered the period right up to 1897, but then we did find an 1886 one as well, so we knew definitely she was at that address at that time. So that was, it was just such a great find. And then we started to research the different things in the picture then. So we thought, you know, do they tie in with who he was? And because his looks are not French, so straight away we already know this is somebody that's not French. So you start to break it down and think, how are people going to argue this? Straight away you look at that and you think, that's Vincent van Gogh.
Yeah.
But without any other evidence, people can say no. But she walked around, you know, if she walked around another corner and found somebody that looked like this, that would have been astounding. But then we found other things, like the rolled up trousers. He drew and painted Dutch workers with their trousers rolled up.
There's dozens of drawings with that.
Yeah, so that was a really good find. The crumpled top hat, he did that in 1886 as well. It's something he had. He slung it over a little statue of Venus and sketched that. So, and that was a crumpled top hat. And then we started to look at... Actually, I saw it was a comment. Somebody had given a comment about how strange it was on one of his other portraits that he had the top button done up.
Maybe you could add a story about the photo that's supposed to be in for Gogh.
Oh yeah, well that's quite an amazing one as well, because although, you know, people again are saying, oh well, he didn't go to Canada. Well no, but Victor Meurin went to Paris, why didn't he? I think they also have facial forensics and analysis experts look at that photo and they agreed that it was Van Gogh as well. And I have no problem with that. Thank you.
What about the other convincing details?
We liked this Bible was really great because was it in his possession at that time? It was a pulpit Bible, with it being a big one. It's not exactly, you know, your small one. So it was one that was identical to the one his father had. And his father died the year before, and I don't know which one inherited it, but it was in their possession in 1886. And because I think he painted it in the year before anyway, open, and it's got the gilt corners. Well, at the time, the French Bibles were not like that, but the Dutch Bibles were. So again, that was another thing that tied in. Also, his books and everything on there, he was a prolific writer and reader. I just couldn't stop, you know, this was a massive hobby. And he was known for writing on the walls, pinning pictures up roughly. The redness of his beard and everything as well. They always make a big thing about this, you know, that it was very red. And that is not just like brown red, that's very red. And
how about the pen?
Yeah, the pen. Well, he was using a quill when other people had moved on to pens. You know, I found a few things that gave reference to this, that he's one of the ones that enjoyed using the quill at the time when people just enjoyed moving forwards. He liked that. So there's not one single thing on there that doesn't tie in.
The writing on the wall?
Yeah, well, I think that's why she called it the misunderstood, because on the wall it says l'incompris. He's written that on his own wall, and so why not call it that? It's such a nice title.
It seems that he called himself that.
And it was referred to, I think his sister referred to him as that as well in one of the letters, and it would have felt that sincerely, wouldn't it?
I mean,
he felt by much that he was misunderstood.
If there's one key word for Gogh in his years, in his time, it would be the misunderstood, right?
Yes. Yes, it was. It's a perfect title.
Having this painting, what does it mean to you personally?
Every so often, you realise that it's a little bit of a shock. It's out of anywhere in the whole world it could have been, anybody in the whole world that could have seen it and bought it. You know, we've been able to, you know, not just have this and have this on our own wall, because we didn't want to do that. We've been able to share this with other people, and it's a weird feeling. You know, you've got this picture, the only full height one of a full body picture of Vincent van Gogh in existence, and there he is.
What's your feeling on the drawing on the wall here?
Yeah, well, we thought that was possibly, it was suggested that sometimes an artist can put a little bit of their own thing into the painting or into a picture, and that's, so we were under the impression that's probably Jeanne Donnadieu herself. There are a couple of lovely pictures that she's done of this lady that smiles an awful lot, and there's a lovely picture that looks very, very much like that one. So I think that could possibly be her. And also she's done him such affection. This seems to be such a lovingly portrayed picture. And so there's also that speculation that were they in a relationship at all? And certainly very close, you know, and in the same profession, they shared interest, didn't they?
And he seems to be wearing a smile. I want to thank you very much for this fantastic story, and it's great to be here, and it's a great honor that you invited me here. Thank you very much.
Okay.
It's already wrong.
I've got plenty of time.